Hello and welcome to Kinmen National Park, located just to the northwest of Taiwan. It is an area of outstanding natural beauty and covers almost 3,720 hectares and is littered with battlefield relics. The island itself was used as a military outpost by the Taiwanese army against the communist armies of China. And today we're going to cover two of the major battles that occurred here. These days were dark days indeed for the islanders and resulted in countless loss of life. The first main battle fought here, named the Triumph of Iguningtu, commenced under cover of darkness at 2 o'clock in the morning on the 25th of October 1949. The communist Chinese army landed on the shores of the island in over 200 fishing boats and commenced their attack. The battle lasted just 56 hours, that's almost 3 full days and nights. The local Taiwanese army, using a variety of weaponry, including the M5A1 tanks, aptly named the Bears of Kinmen, managed to hold off the invading forces. By the end of the battle, in excess of 7,000 prisoners of war were taken or captured by the defending forces. This was, however, not the end of the troubles. Two further attacks were to be carried out by the communist Chinese in response to their defeat, one in 1950 and one in 1954. These attacks, however, relatively speaking, were smaller and much less aggressive. The next large-scale military attack took place on the 23rd of August 1958, when the Chinese Communist Party again tried to take the island and defeat the military presence here. At 18:30 hours, the island was subjected to a devastating artillery barrage. 342 artillery pieces were used for 2 hours and fired in excess of 57,500 rounds. The battle lasted a lot longer than the Communist Army's original attempt in 1949, and although the fighting wasn't constant, it lasted 44 days. The island's ports and airports were strategically targeted in order to cut off the supply line and therefore weaken the local forces. Eventually, the United States sent a few warships to support their struggle. Within the 44 days of this conflict, in the region of 480,000 artillery shells were fired. Kinmen National Park now stands as a fitting and poignant reminder of these conflicts, plus the history of the island. The M41 Walker Bulldog began production in 1950 and ended up to the tune of some 3,728 examples produced. The M41 Walker Bulldog was a US light tank developed to replace the M24 Chaffee. Initially nicknamed Little Bulldog, until later when it was renamed for General Walton Walker, who died in a jeep accident in Korea. The M41 was an agile and well-armed vehicle. On the other hand, it was noisy, fuel-hungry, and heavy enough to cause problems with air transport. The M41 was exported to Brazil, Spain, Chile, the Dominican Republic, Guatemala, and New Zealand. It also was exported to the Philippines, Somalia, Taiwan, Thailand, Tunisia, Lebanon, and other countries. Many of these tanks were upgraded to prolong their life, and some are still in active service. Featured in Korea, it rushed to the battlefield even before its first test run. This was due to the fact that the North Koreans were supplied with Soviet T-34 tanks, which were superior to the M24. By 1961, 150 were delivered to the Japan Ground Self-Defense Forces to supplement their Type 61 medium tanks. The first M41A3s arrived in January 1965, equipping 5 ARVN squadrons by the end of the year. The M41 was an instant success with South Vietnamese. The crew found its interior to be just perfect for their smaller statures, which had been a principal criticism by United States armored crewmen. It had a weight of 23.5 tons and a length of 5.819 meters. With a crew of 4, it was a very, very apt and agile vehicle. Engine-wise, it consisted of a Continental AOS 8953 six-cylinder gasoline engines produced by Cadillac of General Motors and a power-to-weight ratio of 21.3 horsepower, with an operational range of 100 miles and a top speed of 45 miles per hour. The armor was adequate, up to 1.5 inches. The light tank M24 is an American light tank used during the latter part of World War II, and in post-war conflicts, including the Korean War and with the French in the war in Algeria and the First Indochina War. In British service, it was given the service name Chaffee after United States Army General Adna R. Chaffee Jr., who helped develop the use of tanks in the United States Armed Forces. While long removed from American and British service, it is still found in service as a light tank in third world countries, along with other hardware from that era. It was produced in 1944 to August 1945, and around about 4,731 were actually built. The M24 Chaffee was intended to replace the aging and obsolete light tank M5, which was used in various roles. The first 34 M24s reached Europe in November 1944 and were issued to the United States 2nd Cavalry Group, mechanized, in France. These were then issued to Troop F, the 2nd Cavalry Reconnaissance Squadron, and Troop F, the 42nd Cavalry Reconnaissance Squadron, which each received 17 M24s. During the Battle of the Bulge in December 1944, these units and their new tanks were rushed to the southern sector. Two of the M24s were detached to serve with the 740th Tank Battalion of the 1st United States Army. Like the Russian T-34, the M24 performed well in mud and on the snow of the cold 1944-45 winter because of its wide tracks. The engine consists of two Cadillac 44T24 V8 gasoline engines, developing 110 horsepower each. It has a 56 km per hour road speed and a 40 km per hour off-road speed, with a maximum range of 99 miles. Armament-wise, it has one 75mm main gun, one 12.7mm machine gun on a pintle mounting, two 7.62mm machine guns in bow and coaxial mounts, and one 51mm smoke mortar. The development of the vehicle was started in 1942. In April 1943, the General Motors Company produced the first prototypes, one of a few American tank destroyers manufactured on its original chassis, not on a chassis of a tank. The tank destroyer became the most high-speed armored vehicle of this type of World War II. A total of 2,507 vehicles were produced from July 1943 through to October 1944. The M18 originated in the design studio of Harley Earl from the Buick Motor Company division of General Motors, whose team also worked extensively on early camouflage paint. Even the Hellcat logo on the M18's front corner and patches worn by its crew were designed by Earl's staff. Flanked by the words, "Seek, Strike, Destroy," it depicts a wildcat biting down on crushed treads, signifying the Hellcat's mission of targeting enemy tanks. The M18 continued in production until October 1944, when the war was nearing its end. 2,507 had been produced by that time at a unit cost of $57,500. On September 19, 1944, in the Nancy Bridgehead near Arancourt, France, the 704th Tank Destroyer Battalion was attached to the 4th Armoured Division. Lieutenant Edward Leeper led one M18 platoon of C Company to Reichecourt-la-Petite on the way to Moncourt. He saw a German tank muzzle appearing out of the fog 30 feet away and deployed his platoon. In a 5-minute period, five German tanks of the 113th Panzer Brigade were knocked out for the loss of one M18. The Hellcat had a gun that could penetrate roughly 88 millimeters of armor at 2,000 meters. This was enough to penetrate a Panzer IV frontally, but not enough to deal with the newer Panther or Tiger from the front. Tank destroyers, such as the Hellcat, were to be used against tanks that had already penetrated the front lines. The Hellcat was not intended to engage in protracted combat, but to quickly respond to breakthroughs in the line by enemy armor. To aid this purpose, it was designed with light armor and extremely high speeds. Length, 21 feet 10 inches. Width, 9 foot 5 inches. Height, 8 foot 5 inches, with a crew of 5, and a gross weight of 37,557 pounds. The engine was an R975 Continental radial engine, and the ability to produce 50 miles per hour at top speed. Whilst the M18 was capable of high road speeds, this attribute was difficult to use successfully in combat, but along with the high top speed was the ability to accelerate rapidly and change direction rather quickly. Most Hellcat crews found the higher speeds especially useful in the sprint to flank German tanks, which had relatively slow turret traverse times. And such maneuvering allowed the tank destroyer crew a shot into the side of the enemy's thinner armor.